Hi, my name is Sander van Vught and I make video courses about Linux. So if you want to be an open source professional, you came to the right place. In this video I want to explain how my video courses relate to one another and how they are going to help you to get certified. One of my major certifications is RHCSA, the Red Hat Certified System Administrator. That's a certification that certifies professionals that have about a year of Linux experience. The funny thing is that at the same level we have Linux Plus and there is LFCS. These are kind of competing Linux certifications. Linux Plus is a certification that allows you to do a multiple choice test. RHCSA is a certification that is Red Hat specific. LFCS comes from the Linux Foundation. And all of them are more or less on the same level. And what you need to do really depends on where you want to use it. If you are going to work in a Red Hat specific environment, I would say go for RHCSA. If you want to be certified on Linux, regardless the distribution that you are using, I would say go for LFCS. And if you want a certification that allows you to get certified on the basic skills by using a multiple choice test, go for Linux Plus. What I often see is that students are using more of my courses. So many people are taking RHCSA, for example, and in addition to that, they are taking LFCS as well, just to deepen their knowledge about the different topics in these courses. Now, before you get to these courses, the Linux Plus, the RHCSA and the LFCS, I would advise you have a look at Linux Fundamentals. Because Linux Fundamentals is, what I'm saying, providing information about the fundamental knowledge of Linux. These are the Linux basics. The nice thing is that Linux Plus and Linux Fundamentals are bundled, so they come together. If you buy Linux Plus, you will get Linux Fundamentals. If you buy LFCS, you will get Linux Fundamentals as well. If you are going to do RHCSA and you want to make sure that your Linux basics are good enough, have a look at my Linux Fundamentals as well. Because it helps if you have Linux experience before you get to the RHCSA level. Now all of these courses are providing a basic level Linux certification. After that, there are more advanced Linux classes as well. An advanced Linux class is RHCE, which is the Red Hat Certified Engineer. Or there is LFCE, which is the Linux Foundation Certified Engineer. And obviously, before you begin and take one of these classes, you want to make sure that you have taken the administrative level class. There is no advanced Linux Plus. In Linux Plus, it is just Linux Plus. Now, if you want to go more in-depth, Red Hat has a specialized track, which is RHCA. And in RHCA, you will find advanced topics like Linux troubleshooting, Linux performance optimization, like OpenShift and OpenStack and stuff like that. That's a very interesting certification, but most people don't ever get there. Now apart from these Linux-oriented courses, I also have video courses about related products. So the products that we are talking about are Kubernetes to start with. Kubernetes is a whole different world. Kubernetes is about running containers. It's about the containerized data center. And the interesting thing is that Kubernetes doesn't come all by itself. In order to work with Kubernetes, it is highly recommended to have Linux knowledge at an administrator level. Because Kubernetes is about containers, and containers are Linux. So if you want to understand what you are doing, you need to know about Linux. Now related to Kubernetes, there is a Red Hat OpenShift. OpenShift, in fact, is just a Kubernetes distribution, but OpenShift is so specific that it helps to have some Kubernetes knowledge in advance. Kubernetes and OpenShift are very important technologies in the current data center. And I would advise you to take courses on both of them. Right now I have a Kubernetes introduction course, but maybe by the moment that you are watching this, you will find that my CKA and CKAD certification courses are ready as well. Apart from that, there are more products that I have video courses on. So there is Ansible. I recorded an introduction into Ansible and an Ansible certification class before RHCE became Ansible. But if you are interested in learning Ansible, because for example you are a Microsoft professional and you want to run Ansible to manage Windows, or because you are into networking and you want to use Ansible to manage your network, have a look at my Ansible courses. There's two of them, Ansible Fundamentals and Automating with Ansible. Apart from that, there are other courses as well. These courses are more about advanced Linux topics, like the performance optimization, like security, like high availability clustering, and Linux troubleshooting as well. These are courses that I recorded to deepen your knowledge about the Linux operating system. And I would say, take these courses on your track to RHCA, or just if you are at least at an RHCSA level and you want to deepen your knowledge about Linux. And if you think that is all, no, it is not. There are two more courses that I created that I want to mention here. I created a course about vSphere, that is VMware vSphere, because I think virtualization is interesting and promising data center technology. And I also did a course about OpenStack. OpenStack is about cloud, open source cloud that is also based on Linux. The vSphere course is a course that is kind of on its own, so you can take it regardless of the other courses. The OpenStack course is more a course that falls into the advanced Linux courses. So I would advise you to take OpenStack only if you have ensured that you master your Linux basics. And that's about all I have done so far. I hope it is going to help you to get certified as an open source professional, and I hope to see you soon in one of these video courses.